Welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video, we're doing some work for a beginner. We're making a brass screw which involves turning, knurling, cutting a thread, and parting off. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. Today, what I want to make is a small brass thumbscrew which has a quarter inch width worth thread on this end, about 9 millimeters long, a knurl on this end, and this is so I can hold my thread dial indicator. First thing I need to do is take a piece of brass rod and hold it in the three jaw chuck, and I need to leave it protruding enough to be able to part this bar off. So I'll just face the end off, get rid of this lump, and then we can start. Just alter the angle of my tool. I've just noticed with this tool, it's not possible to turn a square face without the tip of the tool making a chamfer or a taper on this side, so I'll need to change that tool. Go back to an insert and use my height checking gauge to check the tool height. Turn my tool round just over the compound slide. Take the height center gauge. With the tip of the tool just under that lip, I can zero this. Doesn't matter, what I'm looking for is some movement. As I lift the tool up, it should start to lift that lip, which lifts the dial indicator and gives me a movement on the indicator, which is there. So I can lock that up, and I know that's center height. Reset this. Because I've moved my tool, I need to set my datum again. Touch the tooltip on the end. Zero my X and Y axis. .264. 0.259. Put a lead on for a thread. Now in the tailstock I want to hold my centre that holds the die stock. This is the centre. At the moment it's got a spring loaded centre in, so I can take that out. Put this in the tailstock. And then my die stock will fit on there and the diameter will guide it onto the part. This is my die stock. The bore fits onto the end of the guide. And I've already fitted a 1/4 inch Whitworth die. So what I need to do now is feed that onto the end of the brass bar. I'll bring the die stock up to the bar. That's the thread. Let's try that on the part. Well, this is a hole that I want the screw to go into. That fits in there okay. And just make sure it's long enough. That fits into the hole there. This should screw in and lock the indicator. That's okay. And now that's loose. That tightens up. That's okay. Now put the bar back in the chuck. And all I'm doing is just making sure that the diameter's running true. Take some emery cloth and with a stick behind it, just polish this up. Take the sharp edges off. Now what I want to do is cut a knurl or form a knurl, because you don't actually cut it, you compress the material into the shape. So let's get my knurling tool. Now I have two knurling tools. There's this type, two wheels on there, and you just force that onto the part. or this type where you clamp it down onto the port. I want to use this one because there's less force on the headstock bearings than this. At the moment I've just got burnishing wheels fitted on this, so I'll change the wheels for the knurling wheels. And to do that, all I have to do is undo these screws. Take the wheel out and replace the wheel with a knurling wheel. Now I have two sets of knurling rollers. This set is a bit coarser than this set, so I'll use the bigger ones. I'll set that up and then we'll come back. Okay, so I've fitted the two wheels in, and what I'm going to do before I fit them on the lathe is just brush them with a wire brush to take any swarf that's trapped in the wheel from the previous operations. They're clean now, so I'll fit them on the lathe. I have modified this one. It did have a big disc on here that you could tighten up, but I found as you get closer to the chuck, the disc would hit the chuck, so I've modified it by just putting this nut on. I can use a spanner on to tighten it up. Now, to set this in the lathe, what I want to do is get the centre of the bar roughly in the centre of the tool, and also align it square to the chuck. Now just check that it's roughly square. What I'll do is use a piece of flat steel that's got parallel sides, put the one side on the chuck jaws and the other side on the tool. Wind it across. And this is touching all the way along, so it looks square. And lock it up. So all I want to do is put knurl on this part, just the width of the knurling rollers. So if I move it across, let's move the camera to a better position. I've just did it so that these two knurling rollers come in, and that's each side. I'll set it to slow. And all I want to do is just tighten the top here so the wheels touch. Bottom one's touching now. And I'm just tightening the clamp down slightly so that it grips on the bar. You can see the diamond knurl there. I've got about half a knurl. The pattern's more prominent on the top one because that touched first. Just clean the wheels again. Go back across. Tighten it back up. That's okay. I've set my parting off tool up, so now I want to go about halfway down, and then I want to take a sharp edge off here and the side that I'm just parting off before I part it off completely. Take any sharp edges off. Well, that's the finished item. Should screw in there. That holds that from moving. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting. Hope it was useful. And we'll see you next time on enots Engineering.